Hello all, my name is Allie and I am the new face on this channel. I'm very, very excited to be on this channel. I've been waiting for a year to be on a collaboration channel. I'm 21 and I am from Ohio, and I'm gonna post a video later today kind of telling more about me. That's gonna be on my personal channel and that will be in the description link below. So look for that. This week's topic is how to survive, what to do when you're feeling sad or depressed. My advice is to find a healthy outlet. Music is a good outlet, but if you're sad or depressed, don't listen to sad, depressing music. Listen to something that's going to make you feel good, something that's kind of upbeat and happy. For me, that song is What Doesn't Kill You Makes You Stronger by Kelly Clarkson. It just makes me want to fist pump and dance around my room. Another thing is find an outlet in art. You know, you may not be artistic or whatever. Go get a coloring book. Coloring is one of the most stress-relieving activities that you can do, and when I would go down to the counseling office, I would get a coloring book out and color. It's just a good way to get your mind off of things and just kind of relax. You can also sketch. That's something that I do when I have a lot on my mind and I can't sleep. Just a few of my sketches here. That is one that I did a while back. Screw the light. It's my hand. And then there is this picture of Oogie Boogie that I drew in October. And I was obsessed with that movie. And then this is the most recent one. This is a sketch of me and my fiance, who I'm marrying in exactly 2 months. So... yeah, that is my outlet. Sorry about the video. My webcam screwing up and my iPod being a bitch. So I'm using this camera that I bought and it's not going as well as I thought. I might need to get somebody to shoot videos for me here soon. Anyway, express yourself through art. It's a good outlet and it's healthy and you might get something cool later. Sculpting is really fun. It takes a lot of time, and it's very interesting what you can do. Another healthy outlet is running. I used to run all the time, and I'm trying to get back into that, actually. It kind of makes you feel like nothing can catch you, like you're just running for something, and you may not be having a goal to get to some place. It might just be running around a track or something, but it's kind of a release. Exercise is a good way to get out anger in a healthy way. You can go lift weights, you can take a kickboxing class, you can go and just run and do push-ups, whatever. Not only is it a healthy way to get out anger, you get a good body after a while, and who doesn't want that? Like I said, exercise, it's a good thing. Another quick way to kind of trick your brain into thinking that you're happy is eat chocolate. The darker the chocolate, the more endorphins it's going to release in your brain. Dark chocolate is very, very bitter, and I don't like it, but I would eat it if I had no other way to make myself happy quicker. My choice of chocolate is Reese Cups, just because I like the peanut butter combination with it. They're so good, but eat chocolate. It releases endorphins into your brain, which they're like They're like little happy little dolphins, like swimming around in your brain. And when you get too less of them, you feel sad. So chocolate kind of is an upper, and it helps you. Don't deal with things through drugs or alcohol or self-harm. Self-harm especially. You don't want to put your body through something that is going to kind of put it in shock. You want to, like I said, find a healthy outlet. Sorry, I lost my train of thought. I've got kind of like an ADD thing going on right now. Anyway, talk to somebody about your problems. You need to deal with them. You know, go find a healthy outlet, but eventually you need to deal with those problems. If not, then you're just gonna kind of, that funk is gonna find you later, and it's just gonna put you down even more. You can talk to family. If you can't talk to family, go to your friends. Go to some friends that you absolutely trust with your life. They might be able to help you find resources to help you. Go find a trusted adult, such as a teacher, a professor, or go find a counselor, a therapist, somebody to talk to, complete stranger. They're confidential. They cannot say anything by law about you outside of that room. It is you and that person, and that is it. And I personally have been through counseling quite a few times, and it does help. I loved it. I thought that I wanted to be a counselor, but I'm not 100% sure that's what I want to do anymore, so I'm just going to kind of put that on hold for now. Some alternatives to self-harm. I'm going to post a link in the description. It's called the Butterfly Effect. It's a video on YouTube. Basically, you draw little butterflies on your body, and you name them after somebody that you care about. And there's rules and stipulations and everything kind of to that, so go watch that video if you know you choose to, if you are looking for that alternative to cutting or burning or, you know, anything like that. Another thing is put a rubber band on your wrist and snap it. I think that's kind of well known, at least it is around me. Every time that you think about hurting yourself, snap that rubber band. Yes, it's a little bit of pain, but it's better than making an open wound on your skin or, you know, getting sick. It's just a healthier way, kind of. Another thing, you need to find resources to help yourself, such as if you're feeling down about whatever. Let's say you are just coming out to your family for the first time and they freak out about it. There are resources. I'm not telling you to run away from home, but there are resources out there where people shelter gay and lesbian teens who have been kicked out of their home. There are resources out there. I'm going to post links in the description below for kind of some help for that. One thing is PFLAG. PFLAG stands for Parents and Families and Friends of Gays and Lesbians, and they have all kinds of resources on their website. I will definitely post their link below. Anyways, guys, you can always contact us. You can contact me through my personal channel. I check it daily. Find me on Twitter, or I'm gonna make a Tumblr here again soon. I had one and then it kind of went to crap and kind of, I don't know what happened. But I will post those links below as well. Hopefully this video wasn't too long and boring. Anyways, I hope that you guys liked me for today. I will have a video on my personal channel. Go check that out. And I will see you all next Friday. Love ya.